I'm MistRazor, and welcome to Redstone from Zero. This is a series where I'm going to teach you Redstone, assuming you know nothing about it. So, with no further ado, let's get started. So let's begin with the very basics. This is a Redstone torch, and this is Redstone dust. Redstone dust you can think of as a wire that routes electricity from one place to another. The electronics analogy for Redstone is going to be something that's very common, not just to me, but I'm not going to use any electronic concepts without explaining them to you first, so don't worry about things being too complicated. We're going to take it one step at a time. So, the Redstone torch. What it does, well, what it appears to do, is just a power source. But what it actually does is whatever power state the block it's attached to is in, and I'll explain what that is in a second, it gives you the opposite of that. So, this block is not powered. And so when we attach a redstone torch to it on any side, it gives us power. So block unpowered, torch is powered. But if we then power the block by running redstone dust into it that's powered from a different torch, then all of these torches turn off because this block is powered, which means the torch is unpowered. So you can think of a redstone torch as an inverter. When a block is powered, which is just redstone dust or a repeater or any of these other components. Basically, if redstone power is going into a block, and specifically an opaque block, then you're going to get the torches coming out of that block are going to be off. And if the redstone dust or repeater or whatever leading into the block is off, then the torches attached to that block will be on. So it literally just gives you the opposite power state from the block. There's an important exception to this, which is transparent blocks. So we're going to put down a glass block and another block that even appears to be opaque from one side, like an upside down stair. So we'll do the exact same thing that we did for the solid block over there. And we'll have redstone power go in. And then you'll notice when we attach torches to it, they stay on. And this is because only opaque blocks propagate redstone power. So as far as a redstone torch is concerned, any transparent block that's attached to is always unpowered. And this is actually true of all redstone components. So if they're adjacent to a transparent block and there's power running into that transparent block, they are still not going to be powered by it because as far as redstone components are concerned, transparent blocks are always unpowered. What can we do with this information? We've got redstone torches and redstone dust. We've got opaque blocks and we've got transparent blocks. Is there anything cool we can do with that? Well, it is very basic, but there are some things that we can do with it, basically teaching you how to transmit redstone power. So if we have a power source down here and put a block up on top of it, and then that means that this torch is powering this block from below, what do you think is going to happen when I put a torch on top of it? If you guessed that it's going to power off, you're right. And then if we put another block on top of that, I put a torch there, since this torch isn't powering this block from below, that means that this torch will stay on. And it also means that if I get rid of this torch, then these guys will flip, and this one becomes on and this one becomes off. Which means that if we want to send redstone power upwards, a really easy way to do it is with a torch tower, of just alternating torches and an opaque block, torch, opaque block, going all the way up. And it means that as long as the number is odd, the number of torches in your torch tower are odd, then the torch at the top will be in the same power state as your torch at the bottom. So if the power is on here, then the power will be on up here. But if the power is off here, then the power will be off up here. So that's a really neat and very useful way to transmit redstone power upward. Now, transmitting redstone power downward can be tricky. So the most basic way to do that is by making basically stairs. Actually, we'll do it from this one so you can see the power. But you get the basic concept. Making stairs that go down. You can put them in a spiral, that works too. Just whatever you need to do to get the redstone signal where it needs to go. That covers the cases where we're going to use opaque blocks with torches, but what about transparent blocks? Well, transparent blocks are going to be most useful when we're talking about transmitting redstone power from side to side. So let's say we've got some place where we're transmitting redstone power down this line, this, and we've got this lamp next to it. But we don't want this lamp to turn on. It's not supposed to turn on from this. Like, there's another redstone line going into it from here, and that's supposed to be what turns it on. Well, what you can do in this case is make that block transparent, and now it doesn't transmit power, because as far as this redstone lamp is concerned, transparent blocks are always unpowered. So when you need to make sure that redstone power skips over something and doesn't get powered by the block that's holding the redstone dust, just make sure that the block holding the redstone dust is a transparent block. So about now you're probably thinking, okay, we can transmit power from place to place, but what does that actually do to help us with redstone? Well, a lot of redstone is just moving power from place to place, or rather moving a signal from place to place, which we use by powering on or powering off. So one final thing I'm going to show you is just a way to make sure that we can propagate redstone power further. Because as it stands, redstone dust gets one power less every block it is away from its power source. So this one is at a power 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, unpowered. So if we don't have some way to extend the signal, we're stuck only being able to transmit redstone power by up to 15 blocks, and that's it, which is pretty awful. So there are ways to deal with this, and I'll show you one of them. Just as a caveat, this is not something you're actually going to want to do. This is to illustrate the concept and to show you how it works. This is a way that people did things way, way back in the olden days of Minecraft, and there's no reason to do it this way anymore, except to illustrate the concept. So, if we do that, then you'll notice that whatever power level comes into this side, comes out this side, but stronger. It's reset back to 15. So, because this block is powered, it turns off this torch. And which means that this is unpowered, which means that this block is unpowered, which means that this is powered. Essentially, we're flipping the signal to its opposite, and then flipping again to the opposite of the opposite, which is just the original value. And this is true even if the input is off. So if the input is unpowered, then this block is unpowered, which means that this torch is powered, and this redstone is powered, and this block is powered. So it means that this torch will be unpowered. So the input is unpowered, and the output is unpowered. We didn't change anything, which is what we want. The whole point here is that we're making the on or off state of the final torch match the state of the redstone coming into the first block, whether that redstone is on or off. And this would be totally useless, except that by doing that, we set the output power level to 15 when the input power was only level 1. And if the input power level is 0, then the output power level will be 0. So we're not going to be changing what the signal is, we're just going to be making the existing signal stronger. And that's what lets us send a redstone signal more than 15 blocks away. But again, as I said, this is a very old way of doing it. There's no reason to do it this way now. You just use a redstone repeater, which I will talk about in the next video. So before we end, let's review the concepts that we went over in this video. First, redstone dust can transmit power up to 15 blocks. Second, redstone torches invert the power state of the block they're attached to. So a powered block will have the redstone torches coming out of it be unpowered, and an unpowered block will have the redstone torches coming out of it be powered. Third, that transparent blocks do not propagate redstone power. And finally, that because redstone torches invert power states, that you can use a redstone torch followed by another redstone torch to form a double negative and propagate a redstone signal, whether that's upwards in a torch tower or to the side with that redstone repeater circuit I showed you earlier. And with that, we'll end this episode and talk about redstone repeaters in the next one. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!